Hey there, I'm Mike Bills with Measurable Solutions, and this is another edition of Whiteboard Wednesday. And today I wanted to just kind of give you some wisdom on how to be the owner that you've always wanted to be, right? I think, you know, we all, whether you got into being an owner because you kind of fell into it, or you assumed something from somebody else, or you started something from scratch, or you bought something, whatever, but you got into being an owner because you wanted to kind of have control over your day and help other people to have a job that they liked and provide healthcare and physical therapy or therapy services to, you know, to the public, to your community, because you felt it really wasn't being done in the proper way, et cetera. So we got into that, and then all of the doldrums of things that happen with staff and insurances and income and expenses and all that stuff kind of start to weigh us down. And I think a lot of times we just forget why we got into being an owner and being a manager, and we kind of lose sight of that. So here's a couple of, you know, real simple tips, right? Go back and make sure that you're communicating with your staff. Because when you're honest with your staff, when you share your purpose with your staff, when you remind your staff what your purpose is, they're going to support you. Again, think of it as a team. You're the coach, you're the manager, and you're the guy up at the top, and you got to help them to remember what the purpose of everybody together is. And when you start to communicate that with your staff, they're going to get in behind you, they're going to support you, they're going to bolster you up, and that's really going to help you get back to being the owner that you want to be. You're going to notice that your income starts to go up, new patients start to go up, your schedule is full. Why? Because you're communicating your purpose with your staff. So if you're not doing that already, make sure you're doing it. And if you're doing it and they're not on board, you're not getting that point across. It's not that you're communicating it wrong, et cetera. You're just not getting that point across. Go back and make sure that you get that one in. Make sure that you've got plans for the future, right? Plans of things that are going to happen tomorrow, the day after, etc. That can be targets like we've talked about in previous Whiteboard Wednesdays. It can be a new program you want to start. It could be a plan to redo some work, some flow sheets or some routing forms or whatever it is, but get some plans in place. And that's going to bring in some order. And order is going to help you to feel like you're more in control. And that's really what's happening here. The way that you get back to being an owner and being the owner that you want to be is because you've got control over the situation and things aren't running amok out behind you. When you walk out of a room, it's just as much in control as it is when you're in the room. And then the last thing is really work on giving praise and acknowledgement. And that goes two ways. One is you've got to praise yourself. And you've got to take praise from your patients. You've got to take praise from the community. You actually have to go kind of in search of praise. Find ways that you can get your business known in the community, whether it's a Better Business Bureau accreditation or an award that your community gives out. But you've got to give yourself praise and you got to give your staff praise. And when you do that, now you're back to being the owner that you want to be. And then you've got to accept acknowledgement from your staff. Your staff are going to come to you and go, hey, I really like working here. And you're going to go, yeah, well, it's a great place because you work here. No. That's part of it, but it's a great place because you're the owner and you're being the owner that you want to be. So accept that acknowledgement, accept that praise, and really take it in and really, you know, take advantage of it. So get those three things in place and you're going to find that you're going to be much more the owner that you want to be. You're going to feel comfortable with who you are. You're going to feel more in control, and it's going to give you a much greater control over your destiny and what's happening with your clinic. So I hope this is helpful, and I look forward to seeing you for next week for our next edition of Whiteboard Wednesday. Take care. Have a great day.